One Sunday, a chicken and a pig went to Mass. It was out in the country, so maybe it's true. During the Mass, the deacon gave a stirring homily about helping the poor. After the Mass, the chicken said to the pig, "You know what? The deacon's right. We really should help the poor. Let's feed them." The pig said, "That's a great idea. What should we feed them?" The chicken looked at the pig and said, "I'll supply the eggs. You supply the bacon." The pig replied, "I can't do that," and started to walk away. He turned and said, "You see, for you, that's devotion, but for me, that's total sacrifice." And he kept walking away. In today's gospel, Jesus is telling his disciples that there's a difference between devotion and total sacrifice. He's telling them that there's a difference between being a fan and being a follower. Now, many of them had to be shocked by what he was saying. They had been with him for a while. Spirits were high. The crowds were growing. The outlook looked good. They'd even seen him do great things. They had seen him raise the widow's son and Jairus' daughter from the dead. They saw him cure demoniacs and heal lepers and paralytics. He'd even fed them with only 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. Their long-awaited Messiah had come, and now they were part of his victory parade to Jerusalem to overthrow the Romans. But now, of all things, he's asking them to consider the cost of following him. He's telling them that they're not part of a victory parade, they're part of a funeral march. Now, all this brings to mind those drug commercials that you see on TV. You know the ones. It doesn't really matter which one. They're pretty much all the same. They start off by showing people doing ridiculous things, like sitting in bathtubs in the middle of a field, or doing yoga next to a lake, or throwing frisbee for a dog on a beach. Nothing even remotely related to the drug they're advertising. Then a voice comes on and asks, "Do you have heartburn?" You say, "Yeah, I have heartburn." "All you have to do is take this tiny pill for the rest of your life, every day, and your heartburn will be gone." But the kicker comes at the end when a voiceover woman comes on and says, "Side effects may include." Then she goes into a laundry list of side effects that are usually worse than the heartburn itself, like may cause blindness or bleeding from places you shouldn't bleed from, or your right foot falling off. But at least your heartburn will be gone. I think in some ways following Jesus is like those drug commercials. Now humor me for a minute and let's imagine if there was a Jesus pill. What would that commercial look like? I think it would look something like this. The commercial starts out with scenes of streets paved with gold, mansions over the hilltop, cherubs and angels flying around, and of course, people throwing a frisbee for a dog on a beach. Then they ask you if you want to be saved and tell you that to be saved, all you have to do is take this Jesus pill every day. Now, not just every day, but all day, every day. And then at the end of the commercial, the same voiceover woman comes on and starts in with her side effects may include spiel. The laundry list of side effects include alienation of friends and family, pain and suffering, rejection, and in extreme cases, death. But at least you will be saved. Jesus wanted to make sure that his disciples in today's gospel knew what they were getting into, and his words ring just as true for us here today. And as the gospel tells us, it doesn't matter if we're rich or poor, the rules apply to us all the same. We are called to not only consider the cost of following him, but also the cost of not following him. Not just every day, but all day, every day. When things are going well, and when things are not going so well. when it is convenient and when it is inconvenient, when it is popular and when it is unpopular. Jesus wants us to make a long-term commitment to Him. He wants us in it for the long haul, not just when we're riding spiritual highs. But the problem is that in today's culture, the Jesus pill is hard to swallow. It's hard to swallow because it requires things of us that are countercultural and, quite frankly, hard to do. It requires us to first and foremost admit that we are not God, and then put the true God first in our lives. All day, every day. Not just for an hour on the weekends. Nothing should keep us from following God, not even our families. Swallowing the Jesus pill also requires us to not only expect, but accept suffering. And I don't know anybody that likes suffering. It requires us to detach ourselves from our possessions and not let our possessions be the center of our universe. It requires us to be more than fans of Jesus, to be willing followers of Jesus. Now, earlier this morning, Pope Francis canonized Mother Teresa. She is now Saint Teresa of Calcutta. And she definitely knew the difference between being a fan and a follower. There were times in her work that it seemed worthless. She suffered with the suffering people that she served. But her suffering thoughts caused her to turn to Christ in her darkest moments. Now sure, she struggled with her faith from time to time, just like we all do. But she showed the light of Christ to every person that she encountered. Saint Teresa of Calcutta imitated Christ's total sacrifice on the cross by caring for the least, the lowly, and the lost. Chances are we will never have to carry an actual wooden cross to our crucifixion or do missionary work in the slums of Calcutta, but we all have our own kinds of cross to bear every day. Hundreds, if not thousands, of tiny crosses throughout our lives. We are faced with physical and mental ailments. We are faced with the death of loved ones. We are faced with a culture that calls us to be self-centered and ruthless. The devil lurks at every turn. But Jesus shows us that we are not alone in what we face, and that the total sacrifice of following Him is possible. He can relate to what we face on a daily basis because He faced it too during His life here on earth. He shares in our humanity. He felt alienation of family and friends. He felt pain and suffering. He felt rejection. He carried His cross to Calvary and died for us. Every time we come to Mass, we are reminded of His total sacrifice for us. All we have to do is gaze upon the crucifix. But Jesus not only gives us an example to follow, He nourishes us with His word and His body and blood. See, we have the grueling task of carrying our crosses every day. Not just every day, but all day, every day. He gives us food to strengthen us in the Eucharist that we're going to celebrate in a few minutes here on this altar. I think Saint Jose Maria Escriva sums it up best for us. He said that we possess everything we need for our own sanctification. The grace of God and our own will. So we must ask ourselves, are we going to supply the eggs or the bacon? Are we willing to accept the side effects of swallowing the Jesus pill? Are we just a fan of Jesus, or are we a follower?